four-time Miss Olympia Jay Cutler. Welcome to my channel, Jay Cutler TV. And make sure to stay in tune with the newest and updated videos. Subscribe below, guys. Thank you so much for following along.
I did my Max 6, we're back at the Mecca, and today's a good day for me because it's been a while since I got the chance to shoot my good buddy Brad, and this is actually the first time we do it for Jay Cutler TV, so it was time, Brad.
I know, I suck. I've been blowing you off forever.
Well, this is the problem. You are someone that's always been competing 4, 5, 6 times a year, and you were just talking on camera that, you know, in the past couple of years, you competed once, twice, so that's probably the problem. We just didn't get a chance much.
Yeah, and you know, when you're off season, you don't really, you know, too motivated to do video work.
Right.
Nothing exciting to talk about. But yeah, no, thank you very much for the opportunity, and thank you for Jay for giving us a platform to, you know, expose us athletes and show what we do. So
that's awesome. So let's talk about this, you know, the past 2 years. And there's always a lot going on with you, even though you're not competing. So your life is always very, very filled and busy. You just did 2 shows. You did New York, you did the Cal, and then you're competing this weekend
at
Muscle Mayhem, right?
Yeah, the Muscle Mayhem in Kansas City.
Wow.
So
how many do you have planned this, that's on the docket this year?
I want to try to hit 5. So there's Vancouver, July 7th, and then there's Tampa, August 3rd, 4th.
Wow.
So, you know, we'll just see how I feel. After New York, going into the Cal that week, I felt like death, and I was like, I wasn't going to do this show at all, Kansas City.
Right.
And then the week after the Cal, I kind of felt a little better, and I was like, all right, you know what, let's just keep going. So, you know, my biggest thing is, it's not even just the diet, the training, you know, all that stuff's easy. For me, it's really just a sleep issue. I run myself into the ground. I burn the candles at both ends, unfortunately, with my work schedule and traveling and everything else.
Right.
My video guy just sent me the final edit for We Did a Day in the Life. So you guys check that on my YouTube. They'll probably be up in maybe a week or so. But
just Brad Rowe, YouTube Brad Rowe.
I think the Brad Rowe.
I'll look him on YouTube.
Yeah.
Yes,
Brad Rowe 22 or something.
Okay.
So anyway, yeah, my video guy spent the night at my house, and we wake up at 2:45 a.m. and go all the way through 8:30 p.m. on my Monday, Wednesday, Friday are pretty much the same exact days. With that kind of schedule nonstop, so
you know, just to humor me for a second, give me a little rundown. When you start, you're at 2:45 in the morning. What's happening?
All right, so the alarm goes off. I hop up, I take some morning pills, and then I immediately start vacuum cleaning all of the throw rugs and the rugs, and Swiffer and clean my entire house except for the bedroom. I'm kicking my poor dogs out of their bed and vacuuming their bed and everything on them. You know, they're used to it. They just kind of give me an eye roll and,
you
know, go outside.
Yeah,
you know, so I clean the house, and then I shower and I pack my stuff up, and I come to the Gold's Gym. I do a little upper body pump almost every single morning, just get some blood flow, superset some abs. So I do like 6 rounds of major giant sets. Then I'll go upstairs in the posing room, pose for a little bit, take some photos, check in photos for Matt or myself, just to assess how things are going. Then I'll stretch for a little bit, shower, eat a meal, and usually my first client's 6:30 or 7 a.m. I'll train 1 or 2 clients in the morning, go grocery shopping, do whatever errands I need to do. I go home, unpack. I'll have like maybe a 2 or 3 hour break sometimes in that area if I don't have like massages or things like that set up. So sometimes I'll sneak in like a 45 minute nap, and then I pack up, I come back, usually train around 1 o'clock every day, and then I have clients in the evening. And I finish up here about 7 o'clock, but you know, it takes 45 minutes to an hour to get home at that time with traffic. So by the time I get home, get unpacked, get ready, calm down and try to go to bed, it's 9:30, 10 o'clock already.
Wow.
2:30 comes early. So,
jeez.
So that's what this prep's been like, at least 4 or 5 days a week. Saturdays and Sundays, the only difference is I sleep in an extra half hour because the gym doesn't open as early.
Right.
But I try to stay consistent anyway, because you know, with meal timing and everything, you're trying to fit in 6 meals and all this stuff, and I don't do well with food. So I try to space out 3 hours between a solid meal and my training. So that takes up a huge gap between that and, you know, a 2 hour long training session. So wow. I'm trying to fight to get meals in order to get to bed in time. And so it's just a perpetual cycle. But you know, it's,
when we shot, I remember, you know, and now you're telling me off camera, it was already 5 years that we did that
2013,
day in the life for Muscle MD. And I remember, you know, getting up super early at your house. We actually, you were doing that food prep thing.
Yeah.
We actually delivered the meals. And are you still doing that on the side?
Yeah, so I still meal prep, but just for one major client.
Okay.
He owns an office suite, so I cook healthy lunches for his office staff.
Nice.
5 days a week, and I make meals for him. So it's only about 60 meals down from, you know, well over 750 that we were putting out when when I had Proformance Food.
Wow.
You know, but it's just, it's one day of cooking, one day delivery. It's a lot less stressful, and it's good money. So
good.
I'll keep that. One of the biggest things I want to change is being here at the gym, personal training people all the time. You know, I enjoy it. I enjoy pushing people, but just spending 5-6 hours a day here outside of my own time here, you know, especially in prep, you know, I'm here for 2.5 hours in the morning, do my morning routine, my workouts are 2.5 hours, been cardio and everything.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm spending 10 hours a day in here, and it just, it's eating me up. You know, it's, as you know, Gold's is, it's a fun place to visit.
Yeah.
It's a fun place to hang, but with all the crazy people in here, when you're here this long, every single day, day in and day out, it just, it wears on you.
So, yeah.
You know, one of my big things that me and my wife talked about this in the past couple of weeks is just trying to change our life a little bit to, you know, work smarter instead of harder. I got to start taking that mentality and, you know, start making money in other ways that doesn't cost me man hours in here and my sanity.
Well, you've still been really active in commercials. And I know there's one, and there's one you told me.
We can talk about it. I think I can talk about it now.
Oh, can you talk about that? So tell me what it was, because when you told me that story, it was so cool. You said, yeah, I got to tell you that story.
Yeah.
So tell me that story right before you
were. I won't say product, but I did a commercial earlier in the spring, late winter, with Dolph Lundgren and Sylvester Stallone. it's kind of a playoff on, like, a Rocky theme, and in the commercial, it's supposed to be Dolph's right-hand man and kind of like his henchman. And it was kind of cool because, you know, they walk in, I'm in a tank top and I'm standing there, and they walk in. We were told not to pull out our cell phones, not to look them. Literally, we were told not to look them in the eye.
Yeah.
And like, don't worry, you know, if they want to say something to you, they will, but I highly doubt they will. As soon as they walk in, they both see me, and they're going to grab my arms. Sylvester's like, how big are your arms? I'm like, I don't know. I'm like, I got small arms. He's like, arms, small arms. I'm like, I'm all legs. He's like, you got legs on your arms. So it was kind of a cool moment, just get to shoot the shit with them. And, you know, at the end of it, Sylvester actually pulled me aside and was asking me about training and diet and everything like that. And,
how cool is that?
And they were holding on filming. I'm having a conversation with them, and the directors and producers are just like,
Okay. I was dying when you told me that story.
So here I am, you know, all excited about this commercial. It's supposed to be airing within probably this week. And 2 days before the New York Pro, I get an email saying I was downgraded, which means they somehow cut my face out of it. So I'm not a principal actor, which makes no sense because I was literally right next to Dolph the entire time.
So they'll still see you from the back, or you'll see your body.
You might be able to see my arm. I think one of the big killers was we kept telling them, hey, I have a football on my tattoo on my shoulder, and this is a commercial geared for soccer. And I kept saying that, and so I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but it is what it is. I mean, that's the acting world. It's actually been dead.
Really?
Shit. I did a project last year that was going to be really kind of fun for Disney, and it still hasn't aired yet. It's been over a year. So I'm sitting here, I got these amazing photos that are absolutely hysterical, and I can't post until they actually film it. But outside of that, commercials last year, I didn't make my minimum to keep my health insurance. So that was a major blow. Over $1,000 a month, I got a difference in pay for health for me and my wife. So that was really the one reason why I wanted to keep the acting stuff going.
Yeah.
Of course. Health insurance was amazing.
You worked on a new project though recently. We saw some pictures on social media about that. Talk about it.
Yeah, so Jerome Ferguson had this glimmer of an idea about a potential TV show about bodybuilders. He hadn't really a lot of thought process into it. And at the LA Fit Expo this year, he ran into a guy from the gym here that dabbles into acting. And that guy had an investor friend. Jerome showed him a little clip of a little short that him and this grad school kid did, And the guy's like, all right, well, that's interesting, but let's see some more meat to it.
Yeah.
So a group of us got together, and we kind of brainstormed for a couple months, probably had like 5 or 6 meetings, conceptualizing this potential TV show, pilot teaser. The relationships kind of fell apart. You know, everybody wants this person to do this, whatever. Mm. But me and Jerome and this grad school kid kind of had all the same ideas. We wanted the same things out of the project. And so we let him and his brother and his crew write up a script. So this weekend we actually filmed the teaser, and they got a whole production crew and great wow. cameras and everything. So we filmed this teaser. The teaser's called Iron Will. And basically Jerome's this old, I'd say in a sense, like punch drunk, positive, ex-Olympian champion who owns a gym, and he's my mentor, and I'm the new guy on the scene coming up. And in this particular scene, my father shows up out of the blue after like 20 something years of not being in my life. He came out gay, which, you know, has a lot of our own personal life stuff is kind of tied into this to kind of make it more realistic. My, you know, many of you guys know, you don't know, my dad is gay. He came out when I was young. We have a good relationship, but so we just kind of spun on that.
Gotcha.
So the scene is I'm morning at my big show. My dad knocks on my front door and wants to be in my life now after all this time away.
Wow.
And
I know, scally, man.
Anyway, so this was a great opportunity. So we're gonna pitch it to networks, YouTube, Netflix, Hulu, blah blah blah. Pitch it to some investors, see if anybody's interested. And I think it really has possibilities, because it's, you know, it's gonna be kind of a positive thing, but there's gonna be a lot of humor in it. You know, I think it's something that mainstream could actually pick up on and enjoy, because it's not really about the gym and lifting or like that. It's more about life and the human condition and the struggles that we have and the insecurities we have and everything else. But what's huge for me with this is it's my first opportunity to actually act, to actually show that I can show emotion, that I can read lines. You know, being on commercial sets, it's not really acting. You know, I'm ripping my shirt off, I'm screaming, I'm flexing. We don't call that acting.
Yeah.
But always directors have always told me, you know, you did really good, you know, you picked up direction very well. You know, so for as little acting as I've done, I've always kind of gotten a pat on the back.
Yeah.
But I've been afraid to dive in and actually, you know, take acting classes and go for it. So at the end of this project, after the first day of filming, actually Jerome wasn't there. It was just me and my father figure that went through our scene. And Jerome that morning, the next morning, was like, bro, he's like, I heard you killed it. You did a great job. Yeah, I'm so excited. So we went through our whole next, this one really emotional scene with me, Jerome, and Chris Geffen, the owner of Cage Muscle. And, you know, it was a scene that in one take, I literally break down crying and
wow.
kind of nailed it. And so at the end of the project, I went up to the producer and his brother, and they produced and directed stuff, grad school kids. And I was like, give me your honest opinion. I got thick skin. Just tell me,
yeah.
should I make an effort at pursuing this? And they said 100%. Like, nice. Hands down, we were very impressed with, you know, your ability to adapt, your ability to show emotion, your ability to understand what direction to flow and direct other actors to make sure they're on the same page. You know, so he's like, I 100% suggest that, you know, you pursue this acting thing. So it was kind of the spark that I needed to kind of jump in, and, you know, I'm going to take some acting classes now. He put me in touch with this woman who runs classes, who's taught Sidney Poitier and, you know, all these amazing actors. She works with top tier, and he's going to put a recommendation in for me to get into her class. So, you know, we'll see what happens. I never want to be an actor. I never wanted to be famous. I just did this because it was opportunities put out there. But you don't get opportunities if you don't put yourself out there.
That's right.
Either. So, yeah, so that's that. You know, it's always something going on in my life.
You bought your own house? You have a new house?
We bought a house last October.
Nice.
We're like literally 2 miles door to door from where the new stadium's gonna go.
That's
property
awesome.
Values have already skyrocketed.
Of course.
So, you know, it's a great investment. I deal a little bit of shit with the commute. When I come here at 4 a.m., it's not bad. I'm here in like 17 minutes, but this afternoon, if I'm not out of here by 3, it'll take at least 45 minutes. But, you know, you deal with it a little bit.
Yeah.
It's, you know, it eats me and my wife up sometimes, but I walk into my house and I love my house. It's just,
that's awesome.
I never thought I could own a house in California. And we bought a complete remodel flip. everything's brand new. I went and I tore out the kitchen and put up crown molding everywhere.
Yeah, you did a lot of work yourself. You know, I follow on social media, man.
AstroTurf out. So the home is just beautiful. It's new and, you know, it's so nice to go home to your own place.
When's that barbecue you were talking about?
I started prep. That's what happened. As soon as Tampa's over.
The summer's coming.
As soon as Tampa's over. We'll do a...
after August.
Yeah, we'll do a Labor Day. We'll do a Labor Day party at my house.
That's cool. I just remember.
Yeah, I meant to say that earlier. Don't worry, no one's been over yet, so...
That's awesome.
But yeah, that's what's going on here. So I'm still grinding out, still at Gold's Venice.
Yep.
I love bodybuilding. I want to keep competing. I keep getting my ass kicked, and I don't care. You know, I know I need to put on size, but putting on the mask doesn't help me. You know, what's placing fourth or fifth at a show going to do for me?
Yep.
Compared to staying younger looking, staying healthier looking, I have a physique that fans like.
That's right.
I can still hit a vacuum. There's an athletic look to me.
Yes.
And that's something I want to maintain.
Yeah.
I was just talking to Dave after these shows. I want to go through a whole phase. I want to spend like 3 or 4 months becoming an athlete again. And if I lose 15 pounds of muscle, who cares? You know, this is about me. It's marketing. It's a journey. It's something that I love.
Yeah.
And I think that's my biggest struggle is I'm trying to be jack of all trades, king of nothing. And that's okay because I want to be an athlete. I want to be an actor. I want to be a spokesmodel for bodybuilding, and I want to be a bodybuilder itself.
Yeah.
So to balance all those, you know, you can't go all in one direction. You gotta be multifaceted.
That's right.
And I might not be the most successful in one area, but there's not many guys out there that can do everything that I can do and that have everything that I can offer. And that's the one thing that I'm cocky about.
That's right.
You know,
we just had a fan from the UK who just came to talk to us off camera right before we shot this, and he said, "I just want to tell you, you know, how great it is what you're doing," and that, you know, the acting, he's also an actor as well back over there.
Yeah.
And he was telling you that how he admires, you know, what you're doing. So it's gonna feel nice.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, people see when I show little clips of me on the basketball court running and jumping and shit like that, and they're blown away that I can do that. They're blown away I can do a split, you know. So
yeah,
I may not be the best bodybuilder, I may not be the best this or that, but I can do it all.
That's right.
that's the kind of what I want to maintain.
And love that.
If it doesn't place me, it doesn't. I'll have my people that enjoy that, and I just got to be smarter about marketing myself. That's a big push this year. Is my wife's taking over my marketing, and you know, it's cliche to say, but I want to become a Instagram celebrity, you know, YouTube celebrity, and I think that I'm diverse enough and I have enough to offer, not only is wisdom and passion, but my abilities outside of those, that, you know, I look at some of these people that have followings and make money, and it's like, for what?
I know.
What do you have to offer?
I know.
Nothing.
I know.
You know, so it's frustrating knowing that you have so much more to offer than others do, but it's my own fault because I haven't tapped into that, and that's
the
main goal.
Work in progress.
Yeah, from a bodybuilding perspective, like I said, I'm gonna keep trudging away. I'm gonna hit if I can make it. I'm gonna push through to Tampa, and then there's actually a show in December that Kai has. December 1st.
Okay.
My wedding anniversary is December 2nd, so why not compete in Rome on December 1st and then spend my anniversary in Rome?
Hey, that'd be a nice anniversary.
On half a company dollar.
There you go.
So, you know, that's another thing I want to. I just re-upped with Anabolic Design for another year.
Nice.
And Joe over at AD has been great to me for the past 3 years. And
very nice.
And Joe's 100% supportive of me. You know, he said if I want to quit bodybuilding, that's fine because he's invested in Brad Rowe, me, not Brad Rowe the bodybuilder. He doesn't care how I place. And we haven't really made an announcement yet, but my wife Steph, she just took over as a head of marketing.
Nice.
So we're no longer a house divided. She's not with Pro Subs anymore. You know, so it's great for both of us because Joe's got a lot up his sleeve, and if this company grows and the products come out that he's designing, because some of this stuff is revolutionary, and not just in the supplement world either. We're talking whole foods type stuff.
Wow.
He's got a lot of great ideas. So I see this company really building, and having my wife on board is only going to help me and her and the company. So I'm excited.
Right. Stay in the family. Yeah. Brad, what can people find you? Give your Instagram address, YouTube, all that stuff.
Instagram is Brad B. Rowe. Twitter, Brad B. Rowe. I don't use Twitter.
Good.
Facebook, Brad Rowe. And I believe the YouTube is the B. Rowe 22.
Why did you make it so complicated?
I don't know. I was in college.
Oh, okay. Is that long ago? Gotcha.
Yeah, a long time ago.
Very cool.
So,
Brad, thank you so much for today.
No, thank you.
Good luck at the next few shows, man. I'm glad to see you compete again because you know what? Having you compete once or twice a year, that's not Brad Rowe. No. Yeah, that's not the Brad Rowe.
I'm a marathon man.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you so much, and I hope we'll be part of the next shoot as well. Thanks, Brad.